After our detour up to Cooperstown last week, this week we're back home where it all began in the Binghamton area. Today, we're just outside the city in Port Crane.
We picked the hottest day of the summer to check out one of the coolest places. Let's find out what's on tap here at Beer Tree Brew Company.
Across the nation, people have turned the hobby of crafting beer into a lifestyle. Amazing breweries are only a few minutes away from your own home.
From nano to regional, or micro to macro, the question you won't need to ask is what's on tap. Beer Tree Brew Company only opened up in 2017, but since then, they've become a huge hit in the Greater Binghamton area.
Absolutely. They may have only been open for a few years now, but they've been pumping out beers consistently ever since.
We started at this location, we started back October 2017. So prior to that, me and my brother-in-law, we got pretty hardcore into home brewing. And that kind of started because of a hop farm that our family started. So we were growing hops and we were like, oh, we want to see what we can make with these hops, kind of like the whole, you grow it, you make it, you taste it, you consume it. It's kind of like a cool little process. So we started going to brew fests as the hop farm, and we tried selling the hops to the different brewers, and we got involved in the industry through that, and we saw how just the community of brewers and of breweries just in New York State alone was incredible.
Seeing how incredible the brewing community is, Chris and brother-in-law Brandon Harder decided to hop into the brewery business themselves.
We acquired the property, and we kind of had been working on different plans. We designed the whole kind of layout of it through many iterations, but it came to like this point where it was like, we're either doing this or we're not. So we just went for it.
The brewery was built in a unique way with no screws or bolts used. The timber frame was a must to match the vibe they were going for.
We had this awesome guy, his name's Ken, and his two kids. And their company's called Emmaus Timber Frame. They do the timber frame, so they did the structure and the expansion, but they did our original structure for the tap room. Did an awesome job, and I think that really brings in kind of like the farm feel that we, because that's kind of how we got our start was with the farm. So it kind of like incorporates that as well as like a little bit of a modern tap room feel and kind of just like a welcoming community spot. It's amazing that they're able to assemble it and put it together. It's spectacular to watch it all come together, and they use this big wooden mallet to pound the pegs in. That's pretty cool.
For Chris and Brendan, transitioning from home brewing to owning a brewery happened pretty fast, which you wouldn't expect when you taste the beers.
2016, I think it was, every weekend we were home brewing. I graduated college and moved back home. And me and Brendan up in his garage, we were home brewing every weekend. So he got into it prior to me joining up with him.
Yeah.
So he was doing all grain brewing probably for a couple of years leading up to 2016. But yeah, I got home, and then that was basically, we already had a business plan done by the time I got really into home brewing with him, which kind of is a little backwards, but he already had it all worked out, and he had all these books marked out. So I started reading the books. He had it all tabulated. It was pretty impressive to see a whole bunch of different brewing books. So he really got into it prior to me moving back. We just started working on recipes, made some really, really bad beer. Really bad, but I mean, it's like your product. It's like, I gotta drink it. Even though it hurts, I'm still gonna finish it.
There may have been some bad beers, but we wanted to know if any of their first recipes are still being made today. The good ones, that is.
There is one, yeah. Well, okay, there's some spin-offs too. So our first ever kettle sour that we made, we did on a homebrew scale. So that's evolved into our series called Slightly Fuzzy. But what we did back then is we went to Wegmans and we bought just yogurt, like Greek yogurt, and we let it sit in my brother's basement for, I think it was 3 days on the radiator. So it stayed like relatively hot. And then his whole house stunk.
Oh my God.
Like a nice vomit.
Oh, yeah, was, God.
And they were gone. That's awful.
Yeah, they were gone for the weekend too. So when they got back home, it was.
People weren't happy.
No. Because I had to go over there to. I went over there to double check, and I walked in. It was like, oh my God, I'm so glad I don't live here. But so that's fun into the slightly fuzzy. So we don't use yogurt to sour it, but that was kind of where we first got the kettle sour start was for that. The other one's Tree Light. It's just a cream ale. More of like just simple flavor profile. It's got a little bit of Kelly Cascade in it, but it's not anything extreme with any type of flavor. So it's not like you get any sort of bitterness from the hops, just like a slight bitterness. And that's kind of like our gateway beer. And we've had a lot of our return customers have started off there. Now they're drinking like the triples, the sour New Englands. Like they're just, it's really exposed them to the craft beer world.
As we talked with Chris, head brewer Dave Knapp was in the brew house whipping up a new beer. While Chris prepared our beer for later, we talked to Dave to hear how he got started brewing.
So I got started home brewing when I was 19 years old. And just a thing of passion for me for a long time. Picked up a gig bartending at a local tap house, Food and Fire. From there, I got a assistant brewing job at Water Street Brewing Company. It's where I cut my teeth and eventually got promoted to head brewer. And then, fortunately, lucky for me, about a year ago, Beer Tree brought me on and working here ever since.
For Dave, Beer Tree is a spot where anyone is welcome. Even his newest member of the family can enjoy herself, no matter how many likes.
I love everything here. You mentioned the atmosphere. You know, families are welcome here. You'll see dogs here, you know, all the time. I got my own new puppy. I have a St. Bernard puppy, 9 weeks. I've been bringing her to the brewery on a regular basis. It's great that it's so friendly. And it's wide open. You've got the outdoors. You have State Park right down the road, which I go mountain biking there all the time. It's just a fun place, and you know, and I think the beer is great. So I'm very proud, and I'm happy what I'm doing.
Beer Tree Brew Company is constantly releasing new beers, but for Dave and the crew, they're able to keep up with the high demand.
It's busy, but it's nonstop. I mean, we're doing two beers a day, almost every day. So it's long hours, and it's chaotic, you know. It's takes a lot of people to keep things going, you know. We're just nonstop, you know, rocking and rolling.
When creating so many different beers, inspiration can spark anytime, anywhere.
It can come from anywhere, you know. I mean, collaborating, you know, between you know Brendan and Chris, the owners, and the brew staff back here in the brewery. It can come anything from food, you know, to something, a beer that another place has done and wanting to do a spin-off of that. I mean, and trying to come up with something new and innovative, you know, and that's what everyone's looking to do.
While we tend to ask the brewers what their favorite beer they brew is, many are not sure what to answer. But for Dave, he didn't even hesitate.
My favorite's easy. Frutacatihi! That is a kettle sour with tequila, or with habaneros, lime, and cucumbers. So it's by far my favorite beer. And if you say it, you have to shout it.
What is it again?
Frutacatihin.
Frutacatihin.
You know, so yes, you'll hear it across the brewery all the time. Frutacatihin!
You gotta get that, it's some deepness to that to bring it out. You gotta go from the stomach.
That was an infrequent one, you know, with the habanero in it. It's certainly not a fan favorite. I love spicy food, so we haven't brewed it in probably about a year. I'm hoping to crank it out again this summer. It's definitely more of a summer drinker, so hopefully soon.
So as we let Dave finish working on the beer he's brewing, we decided to go and see what Chef Brian Starley was cooking up in the Fox and Farmer truck. We got to have one of the tastiest turkey burgers we've ever had. Due to some technical difficulties, though, our reaction to the burger has been lost. But look at this monster. A nice big turkey patty with chipotle hummus, alfalfa sprouts, roasted red peppers, and red onion drizzled with roasted garlic aioli.
This is one of the specials you can get Wednesday nights, and it's 100% worth the midweek trip. Fox and Farmer work together with Beer Tree when it comes to the menu. The beer influences everything from the sauces to the smoking process for briskets. With plenty of experience from the cooks, everything you can get in the menu has plenty of time, effort, and true love for cooking into it.
So we chatted with Dave and Chris about all the different types of brews that Beer Tree has to offer.
They got a new beer almost every single week. And really, I've been wanting to get a taste of Beer Tree. I think it's time for us to pour.
So we finally get a chance now to sit down, try out the top four beers that Beer Tree has to offer. Can you just take us through what we're going to be trying here?
Absolutely, yeah. So that first beer on your right-hand side, that's called Tree Light. It's a cream ale, all New York State beer. So it's got malt coming from 1886 Malt House. It's got flaked corn in it. Nice light. It's got Kelly Cascade as the hop. Very easy drinking. We call it the lawn mowing beer. It's kind of like our intro to kind of the craft beer scene for those who don't really like the heavier or the hoppier beers.
I love that name.
Yeah, that's
that
perfect.
That nickname there, the lawn mowing beer. That's what I feel like. I mean, it's just one of those, you're relaxing, you're gonna, you know, just, it's a hot day. This is what you want to drink on a hot day here.
Right. Yeah. Yep. So that was actually my 4th of July beer of choice.
There we go.
Yep, a couple crowlers of Tree Light.
It's they go perfect. Down well. Yeah, a day like today, it's got to be pushing 90 at this point. This is a perfect beer for this.
Yeah.
All right, so that next one's slightly fuzzy. So it's a kettle sour. It's a Berliner Weiss. And that's aged on blueberry and mango and lime.
So I love this taste.
Yeah, that's another one on a hot day. That, I mean, you can't really beat one of those. It's almost like a juice, a nice little sour juice, really refreshing.
Phenomenal.
You know, it's nice to hear what you said before too, like this is one of the first ones. It's kind of what it's evolved to is slightly fuzzy here.
Yeah, it's mutated quite a bit. But.
This is so good. All the flavors, I mean, it's got that tarty sourness, but it's like, it's the fruit, normally I'm not a big sweet guy. And when it comes to sweet beers, I'm always, you know, how's it, or not necessarily sour, because not all sours are super sweet.
Right.
This is one of those where I'm like, this has got that perfect sour and sweet combination flavor. And of course, with, you know, the beer itself, this is awesome.
You had talked when you were pouring this thing, the color is what grabbed me right away. It is just a beautiful looking beer. And I can almost, it sounds weird because you don't really think of it like they have wine slushies, things like that. I could see this almost being its own slushy flavor. Like, it's just unbelievable.
We've thought about that.
This is the one.
Yeah.
You're going to do it, this is the one.
So we've got that. We also, so that was a cool one because we did Trippy Trees, which is our sour series for your New England style IPAs. We did that flavor last week. So we did the mango blueberry Trippy Trees. So you could kind of compare and contrast them they weren't on at the same time for very long, but they were both out there.
So this is exactly what I expect. I feel like when I mean, of course, I don't mean to say, oh, all sours. No, I mean, like, this is exactly, like,
this
when I want a sour, this is ideal. This
yeah.
is exactly what I'm thinking of, is I want that.
Yeah.
Sweet. So very good. That's yeah, it. Awesome.
Love
yeah.
it.
Nailed it.
All right.
There we go. Now we can go to, was it
Perplex Lines.
Oh, my gosh. Perplex Lines.
Yeah.
So I've only had two 5-ounce beers here.
So that's one of our Hazy New Englands. With our New England style beers, we found what we like to think is the ideal grain bill. So we kind of carry that through and then we just rotate through different hops. So that's got a sister called Contour Lines. So it's kind of one of those series that I'm just kind of working our way through different hop profiles, different flavors.
I'm a big New England IPA guy. And what I like the most is you don't get the real harsh bitterness. And this is just so smooth, tasty, that nice citrusy flavor all the way through, and just a little bit of bitterness. Not too much, because you gotta have the hoppiness. You gotta have that little bit of bitterness. It's just enough. I love this.
And that thing is loaded with hops. Right, yeah, none of it's in the boil, so you don't get that bitterness from it. It's all just like the different oils, and you get all of like the fruity flavors, which is, that's kind of what we shoot for with all of our New England styles and just kind of our beers in general. We don't really, as brewers and as like, you know, we don't really like an over the top abundance of bitterness. So that's kind of how we portray all of our beers. It's like, hey, let's just knock the bitterness right out and load it with hops, make it fruity.
Yeah, I feel like it's hitting all, like I tell you, it's kind of weird. There's all these different flavor spots on your tongue. I feel like it's hitting every single one. There's something on the sides. I normally don't like feel anything on the sides when you're tasting something. Yeah, this is great. This is really good.
And that last one is called Leave No Trace. So that's a triple New England IPA. It's got Euconaut, it's got Michigan Copper, it's got Mosaic. It packs a punch and it does not taste like it.
No.
So that's a 10% beer right there.
10%, really?
Yep. Tastes like a six or something, yeah.
It tastes like it's maybe a double.
Yeah.
Like you wouldn't think it's that.
A little dangerous.
Yeah, you can cruise these and all of a sudden it's gonna
hit you
in the face. Yeah.
What's nice is, I mean, I feel like feel like when you start pushing towards the triple and the double, you start to feel like, you know, I don't know, for me, I like the light beer, especially when it's warm, but everything feels like this is all, like, right now, like, the warm weather is perfect. Even when we get hitting the triple here, I mean, this is great. It's got a, you don't even taste, because normally you hit 10%, it starts getting either real bitter or you really taste the alcohol.
You get the booziness too.
Yeah, no, not at all.
No, kind of along what you said, like, all of these, I could see myself sitting outside right now, even in the sun. It wouldn't be overwhelming. It wouldn't, like, dry me out. It's these are all perfect summer warm weather beers, and they're all absolutely delicious.
I'm glad you enjoy them.
Yeah, thank you. So, Chris, thank you so much. I mean, this is incredible. As new as it is, it's really made a big mark here in Greater Binghamton area. And tell you what, the beers, you see why. So thank you. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for coming out. I appreciate you guys stopping by.
Yep.
Yeah, cheers.
I've been to Beer Street multiple times. I actually live up in Buffalo, so every time I come home, I make sure to come here and visit, especially with my family. We always bring a dog around, and it's really dog and kid friendly here, and they have a beautiful outdoor space now that they added on. So every time I come home, I make sure to make a stop here at Beer Tree.
I'm drinking the Mosaic Sunset. It's pretty good. They've had it a couple times before, I think. I love it. Meet up with a lot of friends here. It's a pretty central location and great atmosphere. They've done a fantastic job with the new addition. Everything's great.
It's got a great outdoor area. They have great beers on tap. Leave No Trace, Super Everywhere, both great beers.
I love it. It's just a cool atmosphere. It's really nice. I love the extension they did. It was always really nice to have that indoor-outdoor feel, but now you have it even more so. So it's really been just a cool place. It's a great meeting place for friends. They have musicians and whatnot. It's just really cool.
Beer Tree Brew Company has some big things coming soon, and we're excited to check that out. And any place looking to get Beer Tree beer on their taps, here's how.
Yeah, we're always looking for more distribution. We are kind of, as of on-site here in Fort Crane, we have reached our capacity. Our brewing room is filled up. We've added so many different tanks over the last year, pretty much. It's only tanks now. So we used to have storage back there. We had to move that elsewhere. So we're going to move and open up a second facility. We're working on it right now. It's at the Oakdale Mall over in Johnson City. So that's going to be the Beer Tree Factory. It's going to be, we're still going to keep production here, but that's going to be a lot more capacity-wise. New brew system, a bunch more tanks, bigger tanks, and just a heck of a lot more space.
That's cool.
So that's going to be opening up hopefully fall of 2020, give or take. We should be able to start production there pretty soon. It's moving quick.
So that wraps up our day here at Beer Tree Brew Co. We can't thank Chris, Dave, Abigail, and everyone at Beer Tree enough for the amazing day that we had here.
Yeah, the awesome beer, the great food. I mean, this place is awesome alone. So make sure you guys are subscribed to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/whatsontap. Facebook, like that. It's facebook.com/whatsontap TV. And then follow us on Instagram and Twitter to make sure you guys see where we're going next. That's it.
All right.
That's the show.
That works. That's there we go.
See you guys.